Okay, great. Thanks so much. Next, we have the great Damon Martin.
Oh, the great Damon. I know Damon Martin. I know. I saw him in Ohio one time in like 2014.
Hey, Ben. When we did our interview right after the fight was announced, I kind of joked with you about wrestling Jake Paul, and you said that wouldn't be fun because it would last like 11 seconds. Did you see yesterday,
yes,
Jake actually said he wanted to wrestle you? So will you accept that challenge, and how quickly would that fight go?
I cannot figure out. I always try to think of what is someone's angle on this. I can't figure out what his angle is. I don't know. I mean, yeah, if he wants to wrestle, we can wrestle. I mean, I can go wrestle really, really high-level people still and be very, very competitive, if not beat them. The notion that I couldn't pin a bad high school – I mean, let's just put it – he wasn't even good at high school wrestling. The notion that I couldn't pin him in 20 seconds is hilarious. So I don't really know. I don't really know what he's angling at there. And then, but the one thing it does make me think is which I've kind of always thought, and this I guess would be further proof that he realizes he doesn't have a future in boxing, because if your goal was to be a great boxer, you're not going to take a couple months off to wrestle somebody. I just think back to my time, and I'm a world class athlete, and he's Jake Paul. I remember my time in 2010. I tried to both wrestle and do mixed martial arts. I was in the Bellator tournament, and it sucked. And I was not optimal in either one because I was splitting my time. So, I don't understand the angle there.
Ben, when you started this training camp, when you were striking for MMA, you were striking to set up takedowns. You were striking to get mm-hmm. to your wrestling. But you said that 3 months you would have time to learn and adapt and grow. How much do you feel like you have learned and adapted and grown, in your boxing over these last 3 months?
Well, you guys saw it yesterday, right? I mean, read the comments on that video. There's millions of views. Go read the comments. Yeah, people saw it. And my whole premise is I understand that I suck at this, but I understand I'm a world-class athlete, and despite the fact that I don't look like it, right? Sometimes can't judge a book by the cover. And that I'm a world-class learner. I understand how to learn things really well. And I understand, give me 11 weeks at trying this, and I'm going to be way better. And that's what you guys saw yesterday.
And last one, during your mixed martial arts career, you faced off and had, kind of fun trash-talking battles with a lot of people. I think going into this, because Jake kind of became famous through YouTube and social media, everyone thought, oh, well, this will be fun. He'll engage with Ben. It'll be a fun back and forth. But as you said, it's been a little bit one-sided. Have you been surprised that maybe he hasn't been better at the trash talk, or did you just kind of expect that when you actually got to know a little bit more about him?
Frankly, it's been a bloodbath. If we're talking trash talk, it's not even a 10-8. It's more like a 10-7 or a guy. I don't think we've seen a 10-6 in mixed martial arts, but something like that. And it's just this guy has he only picks the lowest hanging fruit because his audience average age is 13 and a half. And, the lowest hanging fruit just isn't going to work against me. You're going to have to come with something creative or something intelligent. He just has lacked the ability to do so.